Repairing an automatic water pump controller. This problem started with the water pump not always running when an outlet was opened. My fault diagnosis started with checking the supply tank to confirm it had water and that the exit valve was open. All was good. Next, I removed the pump and bypassed the controller so the electricity went straight to the pump and it worked fine. I came to the conclusion that the water pump controller was probably faulty. For those of you unaware, this device will automatically turn on an attached water pump as soon as you open any water outlet. It will maintain a constant pressure in the line whilst any water outlet is open, and when all outlets are closed, the pump will continue to run for a short while to maintain a minimum pressure in the line. On to finding the fault inside the water pump controller. Here I have removed the four corner screws so I can release the status and reset plate. I have already disconnected the two incoming electrical cables and the six wires from the silver contacts. This plate is held in place by two crosshead screws, so I shall remove them. Pull out the blue plate with the electronic circuit board attached behind it. A quick visual inspection and you can see carbon staining inside the relay's transparent cover. I desoldered the front blue plate, which has three copper wire strips linking it to the circuit board. It was a bit of a struggle just using a soldering iron. Now on to desoldering the relay. It appeared to be a 6-pin relay, but upon removal, I found that only 4 pins were soldered to the board. I removed the relay's transparent cover, and you can clearly see that the contacts are virtually burnt out with heavy deposits of carbon. Here is a comparison of the contacts in the old relay and the new one. I checked the price of the new relay required locally, but they were around $20 including delivery, making it a non-viable fix. Then I checked the Chinese e-commerce website and the price for two relays and delivery was around $4. Meanwhile, I installed a new pump controller which costs around $40. When the new relay arrives, I'll bring the old pump controller back to life and keep it as a backup. I got lucky with this fix as the damaged component was easily identifiable, which isn't always the case. If you have any comments or questions, please put them below. If the video was useful, please consider giving it a like or subscribing to my channel. Many thanks.